What's up, everybody, and you are listening to the best of the Meet & Mike Radio Show. I am your host, the Meet & Mike Speaks, sponsored by New Justice Media, where we are the voice of the everyday citizen. The time is now 3 minutes past the hour here in the Lone Star State, so let's get to it before it's too late. All right, good people, I know I've been going a while, but I'm back, so just had to take care of a few things, trying to constantly upgrade and improve, you know, going back to school, doing a whole bunch of other things, you know, so going to be doing some more traveling this summer, so just trying to get things together. So anyway, look for more uploads. They are coming, you know, so this worries me. This story does. It may not worry you, but it should. And we're going to talk about this. Now, you may not think anything of it. Because, you know, when Edwin Snowden busted our government, the NSA and the FBI, about spying on us with our laptops. If you had a laptop, they can automatically turn on your camera and they can see what you're doing in your home. So they've gotten a little more creative. Now they can see through the walls in your home. Not saying that's the FBI. I'm just saying this new AI, the WiFi, this company, this new technology, saying that they can now see through the walls in your home by using your Wi-Fi router, using Wi-Fi signals. The question is, has this gone too far? Is this an invasion of privacy? That is the question. Now let's talk about it. Let's get to it. Researchers at Carnegie Mellon University can map human bodies through walls using Wi-Fi signals. The technology tracks key points on the body for detection, extending previous research into using Wi-Fi signals to locate humans. The study's authors position the breakthrough as helpful to privacy, even if it opens the possibilities for much easier, cheaper human tracking. Now, I don't know what they were trying to say with this. Let me read this to you all again. The study's authors position the breakthrough as helpful to privacy. How is it helpful to my privacy? Well, we'll get to that. No, I would think this more as an intrusion. It goes on to read, even if it opens the possibilities for much easier, cheaper human tracking. So I guess it's pretty expensive to track humans. So this way, the Wi-Fi signals, like I guess the what do you call those optofibic, those cables, fiber optics, and it's just in the cloud. They could just magically, boom, there you are. So let's continue. And here's the part where it gets really interesting, because I want to know, but I don't get an answer. We don't get an answer, good people. It isn't immediately clear how using only a Wi-Fi signal to track human movement through walls improves personal privacy. See there? It doesn't. I'll get to where they're trying to say it improves. But that's what a new study from Carnegie Mellon University claims. Mm-hmm. Improves personal privacy. What about a violation of personal privacy? But I'm going to tell you about what they mean by improving in a minute. In a recently published paper, the researchers expanded on the study of employing Wi-Fi signals to map human movement, especially in low-light situations that make using other technologies less than desirable. They write, "We developed a deep neural network that maps the phase and amplitude of Wi-Fi signals to UV coordinates within 24 human regions. The results of the study reveal that our model can estimate the dense poles of multiple subjects with comparable performance to image-based approaches by utilizing Wi-Fi signals at the only input, unquote. Now, to me, that was a bunch of mumbo jumbo to confuse you on exactly much ado about nothing, because you didn't really explain. That wasn't even tech talk, actually. You didn't really explain exactly how you're doing this. Are you using infrared? I think not. So exactly what are you saying to actually see through these through the walls? This pathway opens the options for low-cost, broadly accessible human tracking through walls. They are boldly putting this in our face. But you had to dig to find the story, good people. High-cost technology has successfully mapped people's movements through walls for years. And I'll tell you about that. And they just told off on themselves. Let me read that again. High-cost technology has successfully mapped people's movements through walls for years. And I'll tell you about where they got that from. And researchers at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, have spent over a decade working on ways to more easily see people through walls, whether using cell phone signals, through your phone or Wi-Fi. In the Carnegie Mellon study, scientists had Wi-Fi signals send and receive a body's coordinates and then used dense poles to map the body. Okay, now they're kind of saying how they're doing it. Now, from the study, advances in computer vision and machine learning techniques have led to significant development in 2D and 3D human pose estimation from RGB cameras, LiDAR, and radars. So they're using a lot of stuff here, and it's almost like, you know, in those movies they put the little balls on people and they can now make them, they got the green screen, but in this way I guess they're bouncing off the mapping, or doing a map of you, then it bounces back and then boom. Now here's the thing, how are they going to know it's actually you? That is the question. They know they got movement in the house. They know you got people there, but they don't know if it's actually you. That's the question. Unless you have facial recognition. It goes on to say, by reducing the need for the advanced and expensive technology, the Carnegie Mellon researchers say they can make human tracking more available. Somehow they're also positioned the breakthrough as a privacy position situation. You don't need Wi-Fi signals to see. That's a bit sketchy. It is. It is. Now back to the question. Is this a violation of Fourth Amendment protections against unreasonable search and seizures? I mean, I know they're selling it on how this will help people, such as persons in need in case of an emergency, you know, the elderly, I've fallen, I can't get up, but in just case the life alert don't respond, they can't get to it, and you can go there and you can see through the walls, and I don't know, it's best to just come break down the door. But anyway, but what if this falls into the wrong hands, I'm saying, or what if the system gets hacked? Because hacking seems to be really be going around lately. I don't know, but I believe that this is nothing new, going back to what I was saying. I mean, you know, the military has had this type of technology for quite some time, often used to infiltrate terrorist activity or used in hostage situations that can see through the walls. But now it's being used on everyday citizens. Or has it always been used on everyday citizens? Things that make you go, So let me know what you think about this. If this is a good thing or not. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night. Audio Jungle.